Okay, good morning. Welcome back. Today is June 21. I think, what, is that summer solstice or a mid-year point? June 21, 2023, for those in the future listening now. Thus shall begin a new series. Oh ho. And this will be a second pass in greater depth of the cosmology and history of Earth and the solar system given by Ra in the Law of One. So, history of Earth and the solar system, including cosmology, which means in this case cosmogenesis, the genesis of the cosmos, and cosmology, or the nature and structure of creation. Creation being the manifest of source manifests creation. This I had wanted to get do a second pass of the raw material, but this is a nice compromise. Rather than do all 108 sessions, nor or do nothing, just bits and pieces, as I've been doing here and there, now and then, quotes from Ra. This will be a new series, cosmology and Earth history, beginning with cosmogenesis, or what's called here in the beginning. This I'm working. The impetus for this is this document, the two documents of the timeline. And the supporting text from the 106 sessions of Law of One or Raw Material pertaining to cosmology and Earth history. An improvement on what I had done 20 years ago or so, my own ET Earth history and timeline, which I hadn't, which has some oversight, some mistakes I had made, have, did make some mistakes, or I would say it's maybe 95% accurate to the text. This was before, I believe, the Law of One.info website, so I was working from four or five physical books and going from page to page in this book one, two, three, four, to the next, compiling the timeline, which I think is really critical. I mean, to me, this represents non-distorted truth. Not complete, but I would take this over any human version of cosmology, cosmogenesis. It's really cosmogenesis and Earth solar system history. But for those who are not in the same degree of adherence or trust or belief or concord with Ra, you can take this as one interesting paradigm or one interesting presentation of metaphysical metaphysics, metaphysics of cosmology and cosmogenesis and solar system history as one interesting view for your delection. So, to me, though, I think this is the best that I've seen. Of to try to understand how did we get to where we are today, a sequential timeline from before Maldek to the present time. It's very appropriate here at what I would say is the end of the cycle to review the historicity, the historical basis of the current moment. From before the cycle started, then eventually, where we'll start here is the section at the start of the document called In the Beginning. And again, we're going to see chapter and verse or session and question. It could also be called Before the Beginning. In the beginning, there was no heaven and earth, there was no light, there was no matter, there was no creation, there was simply creator or infinity. Pre-manifest. And so, what I will now do is begin the series and this, you'll see, I will upload the PDF documents, but you don't really need that because there's a link to the website from a Google Doc document, DocX, which could be put into a PDF or can be downloaded from the Google Docs site. On the left side, you have the bare bones timeline. On the right side, you have chapter and verse or session and question, which I hadn't done, or I did only partially, very limited, very little in my presentation, my first pass 20 years ago. So I think this is wonderful and true, not complete, but important and true, and a great basis for contemplation, if you enjoy contemplation. Regarding how it came to be that we now live this life, the life around us, the conditions of Earth are as they are. And what I'll do now is today begin in the section called In the Beginning, which is cosmogenesis. By the way, I've also put a link to a timeline of events mentioned in the Law of One from the Law of One Info site, prepared by a bunch of folks, including Jim McCarty and myself. Jim is listed first, but I don't know which document they were working from. I mean, Jim and Rom at LNL may have put together their own timeline, but I don't know it. But this is an amalgam of multiple folks weighing in, and it's very useful, of course, particularly talking about before 705,000 years ago, before Maldek, Ra's third density 2.6 billion years ago, and visits to Earth by various entities 4 million years ago, here. And you can expand that and see what the quotes, direct words from Ra are. So that's a good resource, and I've also added the resource of the site map from my archive site, scottmandelker.com, from early days, which includes the original ET Earth history timeline from the website, which was part of the basis of the Law of One upgrade of it, and Lawrence Manzo's reformation of it and improvement. So thank you, Lawrence, a lot, and it's the catalyst that fit in with my sense that I should go back into the raw material and present more and bring more of this to you, or bring this to you again from hopefully a deeper insight, wisdom, position of greater understanding. So at the top of the document, which is on the right side of the Google Docs page, a quote, I'm not sure who I asked him about it, why'd you put this in here? And he's like, well, so 6.26, Ra said, "You will find our statements at times to be those which imply that a question is unimportant. This is due to our perception that the given question is unimportant. Nevertheless, unless the question contains the potential for answer giving, which may infringe upon free will, we offer our answers." Well, this is certainly a statement that Ra considers some questions unimportant, our perception that the given question is unimportant. It may even be that some of what we will now look into again in the timeline would be considered by Ra unimportant. And they did make a comment that humanity seems to overvalue the past, where we look at ancient ruins and say, oh my God, that was so special, or we even idealize the past while undervaluing the present moment, where there's magic and the infinite creator source, you know, pulsing fully. So it may be that some of this would be considered by Ra unimportant and therefore not deserving of excess attention, But everybody ought to do their own thing, of course. And I thought it was extremely helpful for me to put together the timeline 20 years ago. And I think it's extremely helpful for anybody who could make use of timeline or historical data who likes to read history to better understand the present, the roots of the present situation. So some of what this is here may be considered unimportant by Ra, but it's what they consider unimportant is from their perspective in Sixth Density now of what's important. There are definitely certain things that we consider important that they'll consider unimportant because for us they're very relevant to our present experience and learning and growing. So, all right, in the beginning, before letting there be light, this is from session 13. This is a long section, this first section called In the Beginning. By the way, the whole document PDF is 78 pages. So it's going to last a while. We'll be here for a while. It'll take me several classes just to finish the first section in the beginning. Mainly drawn from session 13. And then a couple of exchanges from session 18 pertaining to primary laws of our system. Of the octave, seven-dimensional octave system, which is the creation in light or of light in energy and matter, the multidimensional system. The laws, some primary laws as they pertain to our responsibility living in this world, which is particularly about evolution. Or, Ross said the purpose of incarnation is evolution to mind, body, spirit. And so you can say that's our primary responsibility and our primary purpose in being here is continued evolution of mind, body, spirit, which includes service to all, which includes helping yourself or taking good care of yourself, because we are part of the all, of course. It's not just other self, it's all. But it's just sort of a bonus material in the first section here. So let me jump in. 13.5. And I'm going to just do it word by word. QA and then my commentary one after another. That's the style. In the beginning, section one from the Law of One Earth History Timeline by Lawrence Manzo, compiled by he. In improvement of my original document. Question Don asked, can you tell me of the earliest first known thing in the creation? Ra said, the first known thing in the creation is infinity. The infinity is creation. The earliest first known thing, known by who? You mean the first knowable thing? The first knowable. Is not is prior to form and prior to light. It's the basis of it's the source of it's the genesis the genesis source of creation. The cosmogenesis is the genesis of cosmos from source, and the source is infinity. And that is ultimate Godhead or one infinite creator. Or the source of Brahma with a capital B in the Hindu or Advaita Vedanta tradition. It's an anthropomorphization, or the term one infinite creator is equivalent to intelligent infinity. In both cases, or both terms include the term infinity. One infinite creator is an anthropomorphizing to some degree of intelligent infinity that creates. And intelligent infinity as a term is a non-anthropomorphic, non-personalized perspective on the nature of source. It's intelligent and infinite. So the first thing that can be known is what we're conceiving and labeling as infinity. What is it? What can you say about infinity? Well, the best, I think, if you want to sort of break it down, is infinite power, infinite awareness, and infinite capacity to produce, which is omniscience or omnipotence, omniscience, and omnipresence. All power, all awareness, mind, all potential, everywhere simultaneously. This is something that we'll see as the questions go on here. This holographic nature of creation. All is one and one is all. We often say, I often think of all is one, meaning multiplicity is a unity. Apparent multiplicity, experiential multiplicity, is in truth, in its true nature, is now a unitive, is a unitary, is a one. The many is a one. But there's also the converse, which is that the one is the many, or the one is the all. The one is the many. All is one and one is all. Not only is many one, but one is a microcosm hologram of the many or the all. The each of the many, whose nature is one, each of the apparently many whose nature is infinite, or one and infinite, its real nature is infinity now. And there is no portion, no apparent portion that isn't the whole now. And so this is every, look around yourself, see the creator is one of the four practices Ra gave. Well, see the creator means see infinity. How do you see infinity? You can't see infinity. You can know it. One can know infinity. I'm not claiming I know it, but and everyone has their own view of it, but or conceptualization. But see the creator means know that all the apparently discrete multiple many items of this, that, and the other thing is infinity. That's pretty weird, and some psychotic people would say that, and some yogis may as well. So the first known thing in creation, the first knowable, the first knowing that we ourselves can make regarding this reality, the reality of totality, is infinity. Infinity is creation, and each item in it, all of creation that appears to be multiple items, the dhammas, of people, place, and thing, the nouns, all of matter, all of energy, all of consciousness, all of identity, all prior to identity, is infinity now. We just don't see it. 13.6. Don asked, from this infinity then must have come what we experience as creation. Right. What was the next step or the next evolvement? Now, of course, there's no temporality or sequentiality at this point prior to creation. We're talking about cosmogenesis, the genesis of creation by infinity. And the first pass, the first few questions here is the first pass, and it'll go deeper. Because it's not just you'll see there can be indicated steps, even though it was all simultaneously and prior to time. It's not in the beginning, it's prior to a beginning, actually. So infinity became aware, right? Infinity becomes, or its nature as omniscience or intelligent or boundless intelligence or mind or awareness is activated. In the creative process of infinity, its intelligence or infinite awareness, sat chit, right? Sat chit, the tat sat chit of source, of logo, of prior to logos, really. It's of source. You see, logos is not, logos, the logoic principle is one step from source. So prior to galaxies, there's a process that gives rise to the Big Bang or the galaxy, then the stars, and then the planets, and then the dimensions on the planets, and the laws. that can be understood sequentially. So before the beginning, there is that which occurs or can be said to occur that appears to be sequential. Don's asking a sequential timeline before time that leads to the generation of light or creation. Prior to cosmogenesis, there is this the potential for the genesis of cosmology, of cosmic, of the cosmos. And that's what Ra is explaining, where in the creative process of infinity, its awareness, infinite awareness, which is called omniscience, second principle, law of light, law of love, actually. So the law of love is the principle of omniscience. Sat-chit, tat-sat-chit, the chit of tat-sat is infinite intelligence or infinite awareness. Awareness without identity, without form, and that is prior to Genesis. That is the basis of the Genesis. So infinity became aware, or infinity was intrinsically aware, such it, infinite awareness or reality, suchness, ultimate reality awareness. That was the next step, if we're talking about steps. Then after this, what happened? Don asks, that's 13.7. Awareness, this such it, awareness led to the focus of infinity into infinite energy. You've called this by various vibrational sound complexes, the most common to your ears being logos or love. Right. The creator is the focusing of infinity as an aware or conscious principle, called by us as closely as we can create understanding, learning in your language, intelligent infinity. I mean, Don, Jim, Carla could not have come up with these words. It's not in the subconscious of Carla or Don. It's not a personal subconscious product. This couldn't be. It's obvious to me. It may not, you can say I'm wrong, but there's no proof. Of course not. I don't need proof. I love truth. We don't need proof. We want truth, not proof. If proof helps, good and dandy. If it doesn't, if it's not available, if proof is not obtainable, truth is ever available to be discerned. The knowing of truth is ever possible, ever available, regardless of presence of proof or not. And everyone who has any smidgen of panya, adipanya, would know absence of proof is not proof of absence, of course. So you want to understand the raw material? Oh yeah, that's just perfect. I have to say, it was just my thought this morning that I hadn't heard the leaf blower and the grass cutter for weeks and weeks, several weeks, and here it is today. So Orion does their work and influences, and you can enjoy the grass cutter. Now just a moment.
Planet Earth, baby.
Just a moment. This is the best 3D training site in the galaxy. It gets my vote as number one. I mean, I don't really remember the other ones, but this, I'm sure, ranks in the top five, top 10 of 3D training worlds, 3D cycle training locations. Definitely. So, after this, what happened? So we're talking about, we're sequentializing a reality that is prior to temporality. We're temporalizing a pre-temporal reality. Even to say it's a process is not so. It's we're sequentializing, or trying to come to an understanding of the sequence of a timeline of stages or steps. But it wasn't. It was all simultaneously, but it wasn't even simultaneously. It just is. That's tat. Or om tat, tat tat tatagata tat. It is as it is. It's such. It's thus. The thus come one lives in the nature of reality, which is as it is. independent of kalpana and concept. So, okay. Awareness, meaning infinite awareness, or satchit, intelligent infinity, yes, yes, led to the focus. So awareness, you can say infinity became aware, but frankly, it wasn't like not aware before. But there is some kind of greater awareness that did, develop, let's say. Even that presumes temporality, meaning sequence. there was no temporality, though we are temporalizing or putting into an apparent sequence that which is, that led to the genesis of the cosmos. But you can say that Ra had said that the majority of the one infinite creator is not in creation. That creation, meaning billions and billions of stars and billions of galaxies, little Earth man, little Earth scientist, that whole billions of billions is a very minor portion of the creator. Is very minor compared to the creator, intelligent infinity or infinite awareness. So, but that which gave rise to this very minor portion, quote, or aspect of infinity, intelligent infinity, that which gave rise to it is associated with awareness, intelligence, and desire. So, creation, the genesis of the cosmos, cosmogenesis, is a focalizing process. And that's the same thing for our own path, for our own soul evolution. We must get focused. Concentration, ba-boom, number one work in mindfulness meditation or in shamatha vipassana, in Buddhist understanding of meditation technique. It begins with developing concentration. Concentration is a focusing of attention on a particular object or others. There are other definitions. So focalizing of attention, focusing attention, so-called concentration, is how infinity generated light. Thus creation, and the galaxies, and the multidimensionality of this all. So, with its intrinsic omniscience, or infinite awareness, or satchit, there then was a focusing, a concentration, that led to what we are calling infinite energy. It's a third principle. In fact, you can say that the three laws, law of free will, law of love, law of light, which totally, that is the philosophical basis of all Trinitarianism, or triadic nature, of all triadic systems and structures, all triadism, not the Hong Kong triads, but the Trinity, triadic, triadism, T-R-I-A-D, triadism, as a principle of multiples of creative systems, of systems that grow and develop, or don't all systems grow and develop? Maybe all systems, comes from what Ra calls the three laws, which is exactly what we see flashed on or in play prior to the generation of a galaxy. So the focusing of this infinite awareness goes from, it is of infinite power, law of free will, law of will that is free. But by mind, it generates light. By a focusing of its infinite power, by awareness, we get infinite energy, which is the law of light. It's akin to, but even prior to the generation of light, we have this focalizing, which is the logos, the focus of infinity, infinite awareness, infinite power, and awareness into energy. And Ra said, you call this by various complexes, so logos as love, God is love. God is love means logos is of the second principle. The creative principle is second, the law of love, which is omniscience, which is an intelligent infinite awareness, infinite awareness. Intelligent infinity is infinite awareness, is infinite intelligence, and infinite intelligence is infinite awareness, which is Satchit, Tat Satchit, seems to me. That is a feature of Source, infinite awareness, which is intelligent, and that's called omniscience, seems to me. And that's the second principle in all triadic systems. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Father, Mother, Child. Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva. Dhammakaya, what is it? Dhammakaya, Nirmana, Sambhogakaya, Nirmanakaya. Something like that. The three kayas, the three bodies of the Buddha. Is a Mahayana Buddhist approach to Trinity as the essential principle of creativity, of creation, of creative, metaphysical creative activity, creative metaphysical activity. So, okay, we get this focusing or cosmogenesis comes by way of focusing. It's akin to what we call God as love or logos, second principle. Then, take it to the bank statement. The creator is the focusing of infinity as an aware or conscious principle called intelligent infinity. So the focusing of infinity as an aware or conscious principle, meaning that which can do work. Infinity doesn't do work except for it's the focusing of infinity that works. Works for you. And so the focusing of infinity is the basis of creative process, or creative, or creation. And that, so creator is a focusing of infinity as an aware or conscious principle, such as called by Ra intelligent infinity. What's the next step? 13.8, asked by Don. Time check. All right. The next step, Ra said, is still at this space-time nexus in your illusion, meaning now, achieving its progression as you may see it in your illusion. The next step is an infinite reaction to the creative principle following the Law of One in one of its primal distortions, freedom of will. Thus, many, many dimensions, infinite number, are possible. The energy moves from the intelligent infinity due first to the outpouring of randomized creative force, power. This then creating patterns which in holographic style appear as the entire creation, no matter which direction or energy or object is explored, meaning considered. These patterns of energy begin then to regularize their own local, shall we say, rhythms and fields of energy, thus creating dimensions and universes. The term universe here, I believe, Ra's using as synonymous with galaxy. Dimensions and universes is galaxy. I personally use the term universe, one verse, one turning, one song. The term universe as all, the all of this octave, I say, is the universe, which includes multiple dimensions, multiple planets, stars, galaxies. Multiple galaxies and all therein are the universe of the octave, in my view. In my usage of the term universe. Universe, there's one universe, which is called this all. And a gecko is climbing up the wall. The geckos are a little bigger this year, and I believe they are actually at last doing a little work on cockroach removal in the bathroom. So we had a combined effort last night. I saw one big guy. I know when they come out. They come out in the dark at 2 a.m. or so. And I missed him. It was my first miss of the year. And later I saw... Yeah, you know I'm talking about you. I saw my friend, one of the local guardian geckos in the bathroom, scurrying in the zone where the cockroach went. And so I thought it was a teamwork, an effort. It was nice. So, okay, 13.8. Thus, so what we've got here is... from the focusing of infinity, which is aware or intelligent or omniscient, that focusing generates the second principle, or the principle called intelligent energy, which is what we access with six chakra activation, by the way. So contact with intelligent infinity is the contact of the upward spiraling light from root to crown chakra, Sahasrara, the top of the seven, crown chakra. That's contact with intelligent infinity done by way of six, right? Six, the energy that's upward spiraling goes from root to crown sequentially, and eventually the seven falls away. But before the seven falls away, there still can be understood as seven vortices. It's the contact with intelligent infinity is done by one through six hitting seven, or energy that goes from root to six, then getting to seven. Contact the access to intelligent energy, on the other hand, is really Kundalini upward spiraling light going from root to Ajna Chakra, sixth chakra, indigo ray. That's the difference. And so, and that this distinction between six and seven, intelligent infinity and intelligent energy, is exactly the same, or the basic root of the two steps, the two-step completion, two steps to moksha. One, jhana. Two, dropping jhana. The jnani realizes his own death, said Nisargadatta, who was a great man, actually, Nisargadatta, in that he really didn't mind mixing it up with the maya of the minds of the disciples, or people who were looking, you know, people who were coming for guidance or help. He really mixed it up with their mind, and wasn't afraid to cut through the jungle of the thicket of views with them. But he was saying the jnani, the one who realizes jhana, self-realization, so-called, then must experience his her own death, which is simply dropping identity, as far as I can tell. So that's two-step moksha, very perfectly, exactly the same as the two primary attainments of access to intelligent energy, sixth chakra, and contact with intelligent infinity, seven. Okay. So then, in terms of sequence, the sequential paradigm, the next step is an infinite is the infinite reaction to the creative principle, following freedom of will. So there's freedom of will or free will for all creators. All logoic principles, PLES and PALS, all the principles that manifest the principle of free will, all have such freedom. All creators, whether it's galactic logos, solar logos, atmanic logos, or the sub logos, which Ra at one point leaked as the conscious mind, or leaked, I think, the truth, which is important. Conscious mind itself can be seen as a sub logos, where its sub is atmanic and its sub is solar, and above that is the logos, which is galactic. These are creative principles. These are manifestations of stepping down creative power, divine, or, you know, source creation. Source creators, source creativity, source creative creation, creating. So there's the freedom of will for the galax, for the galactic and the solar and the atmanic and the conscious mind, low levels of logos. And from the galactic, we have the octaves where there are many, many dimensions, infinite dimensions. So creation is relatively infinite too. How is creation infinite? Well, because it continues being created. There's ever blossoming of multi-dimensions, multiple dimensions, ever are generated, actually. Dimensions are created by mind, by creators at all those levels. So there are regular, there is, these are, it's a temporal sequence, or there's a greater to smaller. Least frequently in our view of temporality is the Big Bang, or, you know, the creation of a galaxy. But then there's the creation of stars occurring a little bit more often. Then there's the creation of atmanic principle, or beings getting to sixth density. Then there is the conscious mind. And the conscious mind, as logoic principle, is busy, busy, the busy bee, that is ever creating. And so we have many dimensions, infinite dimensions created by all the four levels of logoic principle. He's moving around now. So this kind of talk excites the little creatures. The energy moves from the intelligent infinity, the intelligent infinity, and it's for people who are looking to go deeper. Why does Ra not say in creation is infinity? They say the infinity is creation. The infinity is creation. And this phrase, the intelligent infinity. Possibly because it's a concept, we're talking about concepts that are nowhere near the reality of such it, because we're not there. We're not finished with the octave. And this word here, we're talking intelligent infinity is the source of multiple octaves. Anyway, that it's interesting how they not from intelligent infinity, from the intelligent infinity. The energy moves from the intelligent infinity, so we're talking about seven generating six, or the creative principle, the wiggle of seven that generates six in intelligent energy. How intelligent energy comes out of, in a sense, intelligent infinity, from infinite, from focused aware infinity, or infinite awareness focused, generates energy, creative principle, love, light, love, logoic principle, in accord with free will. So then, the energy moves from this intelligent infinity or infinite awareness, first due to outpouring of randomized creative force. This then creating patterns, which in holographic style appear as the entire creation. Appear. Creation is an appearance. It's the appearance of play of light. Life is but a dream, merrily, merrily, merrily. So that holography is very important, and that's why Ra said, look around, you see the creator, because all that we perceive as discrete and many is infinite. I'm not sure. I mean, I have not broken my head completely. I mean, burst. I still have seven chakras in play, not yet finished with the seven. So then, these patterns of energy begin to regularize local rhythms and fields, and that's the local laws of the system. So, do what thou wilt is not the whole of the law, of course. Do what thou wilt is the first law that gave rise to rhythm that is associated with the multiple rhythms and fields of energy, multidimensionality, and phenomenal occurrence that are of causality, cause and effect. But do what thou wilt, or do what you want, or free will exists within a system which has a purpose and has laws within which we experience free will. But of course, he didn't want to go there. And now he'll pay. So, can you tell me how the galaxy, 13.9, how the galaxy and the planetary system were formed? So galaxy, again, I think Ra is using universe. Ra said, you must imagine a great leap of thought in this query, for that the last query, 13.8, this is 13.9, the physical, as you call it, universes were not born, meaning galaxies. So how are the galaxies formed? Well, there's a, quote, great leap of thought from this initial outpouring of randomized creative force, which is power. This is will, not free will. There's no free or bound to it. It's prior to law. There are no laws that limit free will, because free will is very limited, you know. He didn't know that, but and now he'll pay. So, but actually, free will is limited by one's own level of evolution. The greater the evolution, the greater the will and freedom of the willing. Not the coalition of the willing, the freedom of the willing, the freedom of the power to will, the will power. And so, universe is not yet born, because, and by the way, at the end of the movie Lucy, there is a reverse cosmology or reverse cosmogenesis process depicted cinematically. So, the cinematic depiction of cosmogenesis in reverse shown at the end of the movie Lucy, which I think is a great movie. I think shows really close to the beginning, gets very weird, very trippy. Shows some of visuals that look to me very much like outpouring of randomized creative force prior to logoic principle, yes, I. So, or maybe associated with it, but it's not yet regularized. And there's a focalizing or focus that hasn't yet happened. So, as we go from that to formation of galaxies and planets, it is, quote, a great leap of thought. 13.9, let me finish this. Ra said, the energies moved in increasingly intelligent patterns until the individualization of various energies emanating from the creative principle of intelligent affinity became such as to be co-creators. Logoic. Thus, the so-called physical matter began. The concept of light. Light is a concept. The whole thing's a concept, by the way. The concept of light is instrumental in grasping this leap, this great leap of thought, as this vibrational distortion of infinity, meaning light, the concept of light as a vibrational distortion of infinity, the concept of light is the building block of what is known as matter, the light being intelligent and full of energy, thus being the first distortion of intelligent infinity, which was called by the creative principle. The creative principle called into existence light. So, concept of light. So, Ra said, the nature of all energy is light. The origin of all light is the action of free will upon love. First principle of free will, or infinite will, omnipotence, acting on the second principle, omniscience, or intelligence, or infinite intelligence, infinite awareness. Satchit. Of course, Satchit is infinite. And so, infinite power interplays with infinite awareness where there is a seeking. The infinite creator prior to Logos seeks to explore finity, as you'll see as the quotes move along. It's the desire to explore the concept, to explore the illusion affinity by way of the concept of light in an illusion of limits called multidimensionality. This is all 6-7 stuff. If you can follow along, it's very nice for 5-6-7, fifth, sixth, seventh ray activations. Concept of light is instrumental in grasping this great leap of thought. It's sort of a leap from randomized creative forces out power, randomized or random infinite power unhinged, getting hinged, getting focused, and becoming then light, which is a concept, which gives rise to the illusion of limits, which is multidimensionality, which is we experience limits continually. The form that there's form is a limit. That's for the purpose of exploring finity, it seems to me. Concept of light, instrumental grasping, great leap of thought, as this vibrational distortion of infinity, meaning light or concept of light, which is a concept, this vibrational distortion of infinity is the building block. Light is the building block of matter. So the nature of all energy is light, and energy is the metaphysical complement or substanding basis of matter and physicality and appearance and the elements. Four elements, matter, multidimensional fields of energy. Multidimensional fields of energy is the basis of what appears as physical matter. So the nature of all matter is energy, whose nature is light, which is a concept, which is critical to understanding cosmogenesis. This light, capital L really, is intelligent, is full of energy. It's invisible. It's not like a light bulb. It's just a term. It's the same as prana, it seems to me, or chi. When there's pranic circulation, or the circulation of what's called prana in the in Sanskrit, that in Japanese is ki and Chinese chi. It's prior to the seven. It's the basis of the seven frequencies, it seems to me. It's above it, or source of the seven is the one light, and the source of that is this focalizing, this creative principle in play by infinity, which is aware and does seek something. It does seek to explore finity by way of the concept of light and multidimensionality, it seems. So, light is intelligent, it's full of energy, it's the first distortion of intelligent infinity, which was called by, thus being the first distortion of intelligent infinity, which was called by the creative principle. While the law of free will is considered the first distortion of the law of one. So the first distortion of the law of one. See, unity is a sixth ray, sixth chakra attainment, or a realization that the many is one. Well, there is reality prior to either many and one, or a many whose nature is one. That's called source. And so, prior to light, there's no many whose nature is one. There's only intelligent infinity, focused and not and unfocused, creatively focused or focused, focalized to create, and non-focalized to not create. When it focalizes to create, then we find the first distortion of intelligent infinity, which is light. The first distortion of intelligent infinity, thus being, meaning light. This concept of light is the first distortion of intelligent infinity, right? And that's very interesting. So free will, you see the primary three, law of free will, law of love, law of light, is what goes to 1, 2, 3 on the way back goes through 3, 2, 1. Infinite power focalizing its infinite in awareness or intelligence or mind gives rise to light. 3, 2, 1. Or 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, love, free will. It's just infinite will, okay? There's not even a law to it. I don't know why Ra keeps talking about law. They have to get out of Dhamma and realize that Dhamma is a conceptualization of infinity. So it's not really the law of free will, the law of love, the law. It's not like the law of one. It's not a law. It is. It's sat. It's reality. Absolute reality beyond concept, beyond identity, beyond subjectivity. And thus it acts or has an effect. But the 1, 2, 3, so-called law of free will, law of love, law of light, is revert, and that's prior to octaves, prior to light. That 1, 2, 3 is reversed on the path of the spiritual evolutionary path as 3, 2, 1, where the first distortion of the law of one is free will, which is then employed by mind, second principle, to do thought, word, and deed, which is third principle, light. The many forms are, for us, forms of thought, word, and deed. Our creative output is thought, word, and deed, which is a three as well, where thought is first principle will, word is second principle love, mind, sentience, and third is physical behavior, action, which is light, of form, formal activity, formal creation. Mental creation, verbal creation, which is an expression of the mental, of course. And so love is an expression of omniscience is an expression of omnipotence. In the same way as speech is an expression of mind or thought. Thought, word, and deed. The first principle, will, correlates to thought. The second principle, mind or awareness, correlates to speech. The third principle, light, correlates to deed. Thought, word, and deed. And that correlates to spirit, body, spirit, mind, body, And on the path back, we go from body through mind to spirit, or working first with mind, then we work on mind, then we work on body, then spirit. But the first distortion of the law of one is do what thou wilt. But the law of one is a distortion of creator, of infinity. So it's a distortion after a distortion. Free will is a distortion of the law of one. The law of one is actually the true nature of light. That's all. The seven is one, the seven comes from one, and all the many is one. But that still is in the world of the many, of light. Prior to that, you still have a triadic principle which gave rise to the light, which is infinite power acting on infinite awareness gives rise to light, the action of free will upon love. The action of will upon mind gives rise to light is because the creator wants to experience a creation, which is the illusion of limits and the concept of finity. So, then, sorry, I didn't read it through. Final to finish 13.9, Ra said, this light of love was made to have it in its occurrence, of being certain characteristics, among them the infinite whole paradoxically described by the straight line, as you'd call it. This paradox is responsible for the shape of the various physical illusion entities you call solar systems, galaxies, and planets, all revolving and tending toward the lenticular. And so, how do you make a sphere? How do you make a circle? You double the light and you double the line and curve it. Parallel the line and curve goes from the straight line to the spherical lenticular. This is so esoteric, and I don't understand it very deeply, actually. But if you double a single line, and then you have two lines of the equal length parallel, then curve, you'll end up with a lenticular or a spherical or a circular. So what's the paradox here? That light of love, meaning the nature of light as love, that's why Ra says love, light, love, the nature of light is love, just like the nature of energy is light. The nature of matter is energy, the nature of energy is light, the nature of light is love, the nature of that love is infinity. If you're still with me. So, light of love made to have in its occurrences of being, so characteristics of the beingness of light. This is also mind, by the way. Light, because the nature of light is love, the nature of mind is spirit. E. So, Mini-Me says, E. Among them, the infinite whole, paradoxically described by the straight line, right? Because straight line looks very finite, not quite whole or infinite. The paradox that what appears to be a straight line is a manifestation of infinity. That paradox is responsible, and I think it's not the paradox that's responsible necessarily, but it's the description. The straight line that, and that's the idea that look around, you see the creator. The fan blowing, the leaves waving, the gecko and the cockroach is the infinite creator right now. Sounds pretty weird, right? So this... The description of that a straight line describes infinity or infinite whole is a paradox. It doesn't seem to make sense. That is of the nature of light, whose nature is love. All sorts of things are banging around. So this, it's not the paradox responsible. It's the fact that the paradoxical description, the apparently paradoxical fact that a straight line that infinity can be described by described by a straight line, that I would say that the infinite whole paradoxically is the nature of all that appears as straight line form, or straight line, which is the basis of form. It's a paradox. It's weird that look around, you see the creator. That's weird. Or is it psycho? It's delusional, isn't it, Mr. Psychologist? So that straight line indeed describes infinity, or manifests it, is apparently paradoxical. And that fact, not the paradox, but the fact that a straight line indeed is a manifestation of infinity, not just a thing. It's a straight line is not only a straight line. The straight line is also of whole, of the whole, is not a part. It seems to be a part, but it's not a part, it's the whole. It's the whole. It's infinity. Look around, you see the creator. That's infinity. That's pretty weird. Yeah, I can't say I'm there, but I think this teaching is correct. So the fact that infinity manifests in a straight line, or all lines that are formal, or lines of formality, lines of formality, sounds like a gentleman and a scholar. Lines of formality, lines of formal of form, are manifestations of an infinite whole, of the infinite whole, or infinity, which is whole, not a part. He is apparently a paradox, but that reality is the basis of various physical shapes appearing lenticular, revolving, spiraling, circular, spiraling. Basically, the integration of the circle and the line in 3D or in multidimensionality is an upward spiraling. It's not just a circle, it's a spiral, but it's not just a spiral doing not doing something. It's a spiral that has a goal. It's a goal-based spiraling of light. It's nature, but it doesn't mean going up physically. It means tending towards its source. And so this revolving and tending towards the lenticular of solar systems, galaxies, and planets, and even the seven chakras can be seen as revolving, turning like wheels, right? Chakra means wheel in Sanskrit. But tending towards the spherical or lenticular. And that's how people do physiognomy of the head, of the skull. Some people will say, oh, you have a good skull, because it's. It has a certain lenticular symmetry. But this is another example of light's intrinsic nature being upward spiraling, is that the line returns to its source, which first appears as lenticular or spherical, it seems to me. All right. This is it. The final little matters on page 2. 1310, Don says, I think I made an error in asking that question, getting ahead of the process that you're describing. Would it be helpful to fill in that great leap that I mistakenly made? Ross said, I attempted to bridge the gap. However, you may question me in any manner you deem appropriate. Could you tell me? And this is where we'll end for today. Just so you know, 1311, Don's next question is, could you tell me? Taking the question previous to the one that I asked about the galaxy and planets, would you tell me the next step that occurred after that step? Meaning the step of the generation of the concept of light, which means multidimensionality, or in accord with rhythms and patterns determined by the creative principle or logos. And Don Ross says, the steps, as you call them, at the point of question are simultaneous and infinite, right? So infinite steps that are simultaneous, because this is pretemporality. This is the pretemporal. Cosmogenesis has a pretemporal that leads to a temporal. Prior to light is pretemporal. There's no sequence. We're talking the way of it's a just a. Helping us to understand it is a sequential, but this is prior to time. So, okay, the next steps are simultaneous and infinite, and that's what we're going to pick up with next time at 1312. How, Don's question, how intelligent infinity became individualized from itself. How it appears to be individuated. The individuation of Godhead. The courtship of Eddie's father is the individuation of infinity. The generation of Maya by Satchit. 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 Like Gidget. Satchit. Satchit does Dallas? No. Satchit does Maya. And that's how that is what can be understood as intelligent infinity individuating, which is not a bad way of putting it. So that's where we'll end for today, 1312. As you can see, the time will go longer in this series, back to an hour at a time. There's so much, it's such a rich, it's very nice. Heraclitus said, "Those who seek wisdom must dig up much dirt." Here, with the raw material, it's just pure gold. There's not much dirt here at all. This is a very rich vein of pure gold in the sense of metaphysical truth put into words that are as non-distorted as possible, I'd say, from Ra's experience and their perspective. So I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you for being here, wherever you may be. Take good care of yourselves. See you next time, and good night.